Hey Reena, thank you for joining in. Friends, we have a new friend today, Reena, and she's a yoga practitioner. She is also a yoga trainer, and most importantly, there's something different about her yoga. So I tried searching. I mean, मेरे को इंग्लिश भी सिखा दिया इसके वजह से. So it's called contortionist, right? That's the name of a person who can an artist who can actually twist their body parts to entertain, to get into different poses which are like not unique. So that's the terminology which is used. This is like her pose, and the poses are like really encouraging, and it almost gives a J feeling for a lot of other yoga practitioners as to ये कैसे कर सकते हो. So yeah, thanks for joining in, Reena,
Yes,
and
absolute pleasure. And as I
right.
told you earlier, that it's completely my pleasure to be here because I am following you very keenly. I have seen so many inspirational women on your life, and I told you this also that I don't find myself deserving to be here because I was so damn inspired by all the women who were live with you, and they had such inspirational stories to share. So, as I can only say that it's my absolute pleasure to be here today.
थैंक यू रीना, थैंक्स फॉर टेकिंग टाइम आउट. बट ये सभी कैसे शुरू हुआ? कैन यू गिव अ डिटेल इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट योर पैशन? कब शुरू किया? व्हेन डिड यू स्टार्ट डिसाइडिंग दैट ओके नाउ आई हैव टू मेक पीपल जेलस बाय ऑल माय पोजेस? सो ये सब कब शुरू हुआ?
I was introduced to yoga 11 years back. I'm blessed with two wonderful children, a 13-year-old daughter and an 11-year-old son. So in my journey to after delivering my two child, in my journey to lose all the baby fat, I was looking for something that will help me to lose weight. So in that journey of losing weight, I joined a yoga class, and the first yoga session was very intimidating, just like others. And just like others, the first yoga class, I found it very boring. I found it literally very boring, and I said I will not continue yoga. And that is how it started. But somehow, slowly and gradually, I got so hooked to it, and it became a part of my life. Then I forgot about that weight loss and everything, and I was being very grateful that the other numerous benefits which I was getting from yoga, rather making me flexible, was just one minuscule part of it. But the other health benefits, and it had made me very strong mentally. I'm a very different person right now what I was earlier. Yoga has taught me to think from my heart. Earlier, I used to take validation from other people. For me, other people's opinion was very important. Yoga made me very spiritually inclined, helped me de-stress. Now, in every situation, I take it on a very lighter note. I didn't take too much stress about it because at the end of the day, nothing is in our hands. And right now, in this COVID-19 situation, I think every human on earth have realized that nothing is in our hands. So, and that thing was taught to me much earlier through yoga. So I will be grateful to yoga throughout my life, and it's my priority right now, and I will stay with it forever, forever, that's for sure.
Thanks, Reena. But your profile is very misleading. I'll be very honest with you. So your profile, somewhere some pictures have it with your baby, with your family. Today we were preparing some questions for rapid fire questions, and my wife asked me, she also helps me in preparing some questions. And she was like, she's a young lady, right? Huh, unmarried. Yeah, but let's orient based on that. So it's a surprise that you're telling that you have kids, and that too 13-year-old. So you're like that Santur mom. So
No, nothing like that.
please change your profile. It is very misleading. So
No, just that in that social media, I love posting my yoga pictures, and my family is very camera shy. So I'm the one who's always there on social media, super active, and I have this crazy thing about posting my yoga pictures. I have heard lot of people, you know, sometimes commenting that what's the point in doing yoga asanas on a mountain, at the beaches, on the staircase? Why just don't do yoga on the mat? And what's the point of posting it on social media so much? I keep on hearing this, but as I said, I do what I love. Whatever is giving me happiness, I just keep doing it.
Yeah, but बहुत सारे योगा टीचर्स ने आपको अनफ्रेंड कर लिया होगा और एटलीस्ट यू नो अनफॉलो कर दिया होगा कि रीना के तो नहीं देखना है हमें क्योंकि she is getting us you know into sleepless nights.
No. To be very honest and frank, whoever my friends who are into yoga, trust me, yoga, the first thing that yoga teaches us is to be very selfless, and yoga teaches us that there should not be any kind of competition. So that is the first thing which is taught to us and which we imbibe and which we learn in our practice. So whoever are into yoga, either they are yoga students or teachers in my profile or around, they all are so so motivating. So we just love to motivate each other, and there is nothing like jealousy and all. And honestly, Ravi, you have just come across to me. If you will come across few of my friends and few yoga teachers, they are much, much, much better than me.
That's nice. That's so inspiring and really humble of you. So we'll get on to knowing you well. So I have a couple of rapid fire questions. I also have questions, specific questions for each of your photograph that you posted. So we'll also get to that. So let's. You're ready with the rapid fire?
Yeah. I'm all set. All set.
Okay. So you have compliments also coming in. Madhu is saying that such a beautiful soul and humble.
Thank you, Madhu.
Okay, so you've already answered about when did it start. So who's the inspiration now? You know, you've decided that you'll be inspiration for others.
To be honest, now I don't want to sound cliched, but you know, every person, even a small child, is an inspiration to me, because because whoever I meet, like Ravi, today I met you. I really admire the way you speak, the way you conduct. So for me, wisdom is inspiring. So any person, any child who can teach me anything is inspiring. And I always tell my children also and everybody that there should be no end to the greed of learning. The learning should never end. You should never feel complacent that I know everything. Now it's the end. It's nothing. There is lot to learn, lot to read, lot to travel. So it's an endless journey. So whoever I come across, I learn. Even today, after this live session, I'm sure I will be learning so much from you also.
So next question, does your maid have medical insurance? And have you secured her life? मतलब इतने सारे आप poses करते हो घर में, you know, there might be times when she just ends up and you're getting shocked. Oh no, what is this? So did you surprise her? Does your family members get surprised with your poses?
Yeah. They are like, see, right now when I'm at home, they are my photographers. So I just hand over my phone and ask them to click pictures. So in not even the wildest dream that they think that she will do something weird on the terrace or on the staircase. And they are like, now what are you up to? Now what do you want to do? What is this? I get to hear all that every day. So now I am like become very thick skinned and I'm used to hearing all that.
So they're also prepared, you know, they're also excited to, you know.
So one fine day I asked them to click a picture, and that was a very simple yoga picture. And my children were like, Mama, this is very simple. We can't expect this from you.
Okay, so let's quickly talk about some of the pictures and also, you know, mix that with rapid fire questions. So yeah. can you talk about this particular picture? I mean, is this inspired by a Conjuring movie or kya tha ye? Staircase.
See, when if somebody asks you corona kaisa dikhta hai, so I can say the virus must be looking like this only. So again, in this lockdown, I have learned that I realized that my house has very beautiful corners. Even my staircase are so beautiful. I'm staying in this house from the past 8 years. And in this 8 years, in my journey, in my everyday schedule, I forgot to appreciate my own house. So this lockdown period is letting me do that. So I'm using every corner and it's just trying to be grateful to my stairs also, which is every day helping me to climb up and down.
Yeah, and I love the your house and the theme. You know, it's very traditional. You know, wo yoga ke values ghar pe bhi dikh rahe hain charon taraf.
Yeah, it's like my husband is loved in, he's into designing, so he has designed the house, and I'm like, I'm feeling so bad that I never sat and I never appreciated it, and so this 2 months of lockdown had made me do this.
Okay, now let's talk about this particular picture. मतलब हम लोग को बताया गया कि ऑटो वालों को अगर हायर करना है, you have to like ask भैया आप गच्चीपुरी आओगे या you know बेगमपेट आओगे, but what is this style of asking an auto wala?
When they ask for more money, so I did this so that he don't charge me high. अच्छा अच्छा मैडम बैठ जाइए.
So can you tell us something about this particular scene? You know, whose idea was this, and you know, how did you come up?
Completely my very dear friend Bunty Verma, who is the photographer. He is the one who clicks all my yoga pictures. He runs the photography page with Red Dot Photography. His name is Bunty Verma. It's all his idea. He told me one fine day that, Reena, I want you to come along and wear a yellow pant. And I was like, okay. I just wore it and I went, and he told me that I want you to pose near an auto. So that's what I did.
I see that the auto wala is missing from that scene. So what happened to him? Did he run away or?
Exactly. I asked him, भैया मैं यहाँ पे फोटो खींचू तो आपको कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है ना? He said, okay. Obviously, he must have thought I will stand like this for a picture. He never thought I will be doing this. So as soon as Bunty, the photographer, was ready with the picture and I did this, so he said, madam, मुझे निर्वाटो से निकलने दीजिए.
So what were the people staring? You know, outdoor photography is very
tough. Once I did a shoot and there were like around 4 to 5 people stood there and they were watching as if some shoot was going on, and they were like don't know what to say, they were like jaw dropped. So but now I am used to this, so to get a good picture, yeah, we have to face all this. But yeah, I enjoy doing it.
Okay, the next picture. I mean, थोड़े पहले आप पैदा होते तो पता होता था हम लोग को. I would have scored more marks. I didn't know that you have to read books this way. So what's the story behind this?
Actually, according to me, this is a very simple pick. See, whenever I'm about to sleep or I'm sitting at home, I keep on stretching, and all this is very natural to me. So I am not finding it anything wrong in this.
So हमारे marks थोड़े ज़्यादा हो जाते हैं. थोड़ा पहले आपको पैदा होना था, so that we didn't know what is the actual size. And this image is awesome. Oh. You know.
Yeah, my birthday is coming. My birthday is coming in a month, and again I have planned a picture. Every birthday, I cut the cake in a different way, in a yogic way. So I am doing this from the past 3 years. I hope I can keep continuing doing it. So even this year, I'm thinking I will do some crazy thing like this.
And this one is awesome. You know, people go there, go to Goa, to the beach to relax. But you know, we didn't know aisa relax karna chahiye. So can you tell about this picture?
I love beaches. I am very fond of beaches, and Goa I visit once in a year. So whenever I go, I just make it a point to click very good pictures around the beaches. So I dress up there, and I do. This is what I love doing. So I just do people. Whenever people go to the beaches, they wear the flola dresses and the flowy dresses, and click. I could see so many females doing it. But I enjoy doing yoga there and taking the pictures, because the near the beaches, the pictures comes out really well, really well. Again, after listening to this live, I am sure I will be hearing a lot of comments that, Reena, you are losing out the essence of yoga and your life is all about pictures. But please don't take me wrong. This is just for the sake of my happiness, and this is just what I love. But yoga as a practice is very sacred and the essence of yoga is very different from what I do in front, in social media.
Okay, let's talk about this picture. How many people have you scared?
No, actually people were not able to make out. I'm already on, in my one arm is already there. So this was on a bridge one day, as usual. That was the idea of my photographer friend Bunty. See, one fine day he told me, there is a very beautiful bridge, Reena, would you mind posing? I said, okay, let's go.
Okay, so is this in Begumpet or was it in Shamirpet? Which location?
This is that, I'm very bad at roads. This is at, ahead of Banjara Hills and Panjagutta, that side.
Okay, good. So we have a question from Sapna Agarwal. Reena, where did you learn this art from?
I did my teacher training from Anahata, Tirumalgiri. So that was a 3-month teacher training course, which I done there. And then after that, I have not taken any professional certification, or I have not done any advanced. It's all self-practice. It's with the help of the YouTube videos and tutorials, I did it. And I keep telling everybody the same thing, that in yoga, the self-practice is very, very important. No doubt the certification is there. During the certification, you learn a lot about anatomy, you learn a lot about yoga sutras. But the end of the day, it's your self-practice which will bring a lot of difference in you.
Okay, cool. Any specific position which you're still working on, or you know, you still have lot more to do.
There are a list of 100 lot more, so it's okay. Coming up. So if I stay alive till 80, 100 or the age of 100, I have lot more in store.
You will definitely stay alive. I mean, you have to make jealous.
Don't
people around you. So yeah, paka, matlab 100 paka.
No, but that lady whose picture was going viral, if you would have seen, the old lady, 99-year-old, she was doing yoga and it was viral. So that's my dream. That's my dream. That one day at that age, I will be doing yoga and people will be sharing that all over.
Super. So next question. What is the advice you have for new starters? Is there any age limit or you can start any movement? So what's your advice on that?
There is no age limit for yoga, because as I was never into fitness. I was never into physical activity. My parents are still surprised when I do all this, because they still remember that in school or in my college, I never ran also. Even I was very lazy to run also. And even after marriage, I was never into any physical activity or anything. So after my 2 children, I took up yoga, and now I'm practicing it. So again, it's not that yoga can, if you have started young, then you can do yoga. Yoga has no age bar. You can start at any age. And I teach at school also. I go to a couple of Montessori schools where my students are 2 years of age, all the toddlers, where the teachers find to handle them, but they are waiting for me for the yoga sessions. So again, a 2-year-old to 100-year-old, that's the age graph. And yoga can be begun whenever you feel like you can start it off. Never think that it's too late. At least in yoga, I can promise that there is never a moment it's too late. You can start anytime.
Why do you think the women at a certain age, after they get married, they, you know, they have babies, and you know, at a certain stage they quit you know, working on themselves, you know, they dedicate themselves so much to the family that apne bare mein bhool jate hain apne.
That
is the majority of issue in India. Why do you think?
Because I would say all women are very giving. You know, most of the women you must have come across all are mostly selfless and are givers. So once they have children, so they love to sacrifice their passion and everything for the love of their children, their family. And And I really respect that. There is nothing wrong in taking care of your children and household and everything. But at least I always tell everybody that take out time for yourself. If I am into yoga, that doesn't mean I have forgotten my children, family. I cook for them. I play with them. But it's all about balance, how you balance. So I don't take early morning sessions. The reason is not that I don't wake up early. The reason is my children are not off to school. So I take sessions only after my kids are off to school. So in that period of time, I take all my sessions. And in the evening when they are back, I'm right there. So I have planned my schedule that way so that I can give time to my family also, my children also, to my kitchen also, and to myself also. So this way, there will be no guilt. There will be no guilt. And as I say, a happy mother, happy child, happy family. So I always tell every woman that please keep your passion alive. Do what you love to do, because if you will be happy and healthy, definitely that will reflect in your family.
Yeah, but you know, these are things which are like really nice to listen, but nahi karte. So, you know, we still have a lot of women, and especially talking about women is because, you know, men at least, you know, go to work, you know, take time for fitness and all that. We also have a category of men who are like calm bahut hai, but they're not like taking time about fitness. But for women, you know, we have come to a stage where even for educating that you have to take your iron, you know, supplements or, you know, regular iron or calcium. We have to create an ad campaign and educate everybody across India. So what is that we can do to ensure that everybody is, you know, getting into yoga, taking care of their health, mental health? What are those things we can do?
See, I always, it's all about priority and it's all about taking out time. You would have noticed everybody is watching Netflix, Prime Video. Everybody are having time for parties. Everybody have time for all that, those things. And when, as soon as you take out the topic of yoga, are yaar, time kahan milta hai ye sab cheez ka? So that is just the mind block. Because when a person can spend 3 hours in front of a television or inside a theater hall, so that same person can take out 1 hour in the morning or evening for themselves. So again, it's all about priority. Because and there are many people around who have not experienced it. Yoga is more about experience. However I say good things about yoga, you will not understand until and unless you practice and you experience. So it's an experience. Once you have to give it a try, you have to make a point to wake up early and move out of the house or do it at your home also. And then when you will start seeing changes in you, you will see the difference, then you will get hooked to it.
How much time do you spend and do you recommend in a day we should allocate, like 30 minutes or 1 hour per day
For yoga? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I for myself, I practice for 1 hour and then I keep taking sessions. So even on that, while demonstrating and guiding, I do it a little bit. So that way, the whole day I'm doing.
So what tell something about yourself when you were in, you know, in the school, like the memories in the school, like before 10K.
When I was in school and college days.
Nothing about yoga. It is not about your fitness and yoga. So what was Reena at that time?
I was like, as I told you in the beginning, that I'm a very different person right now. I have spoken so much. Earlier in my school days, in my college days, I was very introvert. I was, whenever the teacher used to take attendance in the class, even I was feeling shy to say, just say, yes, ma'am. That was the moment of, you know, used to give me jitters. I was such an introvert. I never used to meet people. Even when I was at home, there was a gathering. I used to hide myself in the room. My mom used to say, please socialize, meet all the uncle aunties, do this, do that. And that was not my cup of tea at all. I was like complete introvert. Even in the classroom, always the teacher, in the parents-teacher meeting, the teacher used to say, she is the most quiet child in the class. She hardly utters a word. So I was a school to home, home to school. I was quiet. I was not into any physical activity. And I never wanted to be on the limelight ever. So that's why I never participate in a debate, or I never participate in any competitions or anything, because I was very scared of all that. I don't know why. And today when I do all this, I still get calls from my parents that, what is this? Earlier you were never into all this. Now I love to meet people. Now I love to socialize. I love to talk. I love to make friends. Earlier it was not there. I was like not a very bright child. I was a mediocre child, and no major dreams, not career oriented at all. Whatever my parents used to say, I used to say. My parents said, do BCom. I was like, I did BCom. My parents said, get married. I got married. That is how it was.
So honestly, tell me, Reena, does your husband get jealous because you're now, becoming famous and articles are
No. This is because of him only. Because until and unless you don't have a supportive husband and in-laws, a woman can't achieve much. At least not with their whole heart. So my mother-in-law and my husband are so supportive that it is giving you happiness, you do it. Even I was not willing to teach. My mother-in-law was after my life. Why don't you teach? You look at Ramdev Baba. See, he is changing lives. So he is getting so many blessings. My mother-in-law is still telling me that you don't charge a penny to anybody. You just tell them to bless you. So you just teach yoga just like Ramdev Baba. That is what she still tells me.
Good. So what is the weirdest thing you've done in your school or college?
Joe. Nothing at all. Nothing. I don't have any stories to say about that.
You should have either done it. You know, there are kids who do it, who take the initiative, or you'll be part of the group who, you know, as a group, you would have done something weird. So ye dono mein pakka kuch na kuch hota hai. So tell one weird thing which you've done in school or college, which you'll remember for life. Matlab, school ke din, college ke din aate hi, you know, that will strike your mind.
Honestly, I have not done anything. I was like always scared of people around me, and I always had that jitters and fret. I don't know why. So I never did anything. I always wanted to be in the good books of everybody, the teachers, parents, relatives. So I always used to be very quiet, and whenever I find that my friend or my gang or anybody are up to something, I used to, you know, just unfriend them. I never used to talk to them. And I just used to be to myself. Sometimes there was times in my class when I never had any friends, and I used to sit at one corner in the classroom. So, but still I was okay with it. I don't know why I was like that. Today when I sit and I realize, I'm like, I would have done so much. There are times when I sit and think that if I wish I would have started during my school days. But again, everything has its own right time. So I'm very sorry about that. I don't have any interesting story to share about it. I don't know. I should have had.
Yeah, you're hiding it. I still don't believe you.
No. Seriously. It's nothing at all.
Okay. We have a question from Sirisha, my wife. Does your kid, husband and kids do yoga along with you?
They do forceful yoga. Means if I force them to do it, they do it. But due to this lockdown, I have made my husband do it. So now he's doing yoga and exercises on a regular basis. My kids enjoy it during holidays. Both my kids are quite flexible. They are not doing it very regularly, but yes, they do. And they are aware of all the asanas, name and everything.
That's nice. So what's your favorite junk food?
I love food. I'm a foodie. I love every food. You just name it and I love it. That's the reason I do yoga the whole day. That is the main reason. I think I should tell people that when people ask me why you started yoga, so I can eat a lot of food. But it's not that I eat junk every day, but I make it at home and I eat it. Once in a week, outside binging, I do. Otherwise, even at home, I love home-cooked food. I love fruits. I love vegetables. I love desserts. I'm such a foodie, I can't tell you. So diet is something is not in my books.
Yeah. So somebody who is really not able to control food, but, you know, want to eat a lot, still maintain themselves, I think yoga is the solution for it. That's the only solution I would say. So yeah. what's your favorite junk food in Hyderabad, in around Hyderabad, and which place?
Hyderabad, I like the street food. I'm into that bhel puri, pani puri on the streets. On the PG road, I go sometimes, and there are a lot of kiosks on the roads and all. So I love eating out there sometimes, yes. Actually, being a yoga instructor, I should not be saying this, and I should not be encouraging people to eat all this. But again, see, after all, end of the day, we are humans, and the food gives me happiness. And I have not made it a habit of eating outside food. Yes, I eat just once a week outside. And whenever I have, I love cooking at home. So I have made, I make pizzas, I make burgers, I make everything at home. So in my mind, it is that if I'm cooking at home, it's very hygienic and it's not that unhealthy because I'm cooking it.
Good. So if you've been asked to promote a product, you know, and what is the product you would refuse to promote? Like if you've seen a lot of anti-ads which are going on campaigns.
If I have to promote something, what will I promote?
Yeah, what will you refuse to promote?
I would love to promote yoga mats. So if people will take a, if people will spend on yoga mat, they definitely will practice yoga. So I will promote a yoga mat.
So what is the product you will refuse to promote?
I refuse to promote. I refuse to promote all those things which says, "Ye khane se you will lose weight. Eating this will make you lose weight. Eating this will give you a glowing skin. Eating this will give." It's not. It's. I don't believe in all that because in this my journey of this fitness, I have just realized that drinking lots of water and eating lot of fruits gives you a glowing skin, good hair. There is no supplements for good skin, hair or anything. And there is not a, there is no tablets or no powders which will make you slim. Only a healthy, proper diet and proper exercise can make you slim. Nothing else.
Nothing else. Good point. So, Reena, if you're given a time machine and if you can go back to, you know, the past, where would you go? Which location and what time?
I don't want to go back because I am really, I'm the most happiest from the time I started my yoga journey. So if I have to go back, if I'm forcefully asked to go back, I will just go 3-4 years back more. So I will practice more and I will reach out to more people. And that way I will able to spread yoga to as many people as possible. So because I always think that the past 11 years had been very precious in my life. And it was a life-changing experience, life-changing moment, I can say. So definitely I can go back till there. I can go back 10 years back from the time where I started practicing my yoga.
So Reena, how does your fridge look? Fridge mein kya kya hai? What is that favorite thing of yours which is always stacked in the fridge?
Fridge mein, I love chocolates, but I don't stack it up. So, but yeah, sometimes. But yeah, in my fridge, I'm dead sure you will never find a cold water bottle. You will never find cold drink. You will never find all that junks, outside junks and all that. Yes, it's full of fruits, veggies, paneer, tofu, broccoli, all that, all the salad things and all those stuff will be there. And on the junk side, you will find a few chocolates maybe.
Nice. So, fridge ke bahar kya laga rehta hai? So what are things you stick on your fridge? So how does your fridge
look? Oh, on the stick, it's all the souvenirs where I have traveled till now, and I'm missing my travel this year. This year in May, I'm not able to travel, so I'm missing it. But again, things will be better, and hopefully, praying by next year, we all will able to travel, and my refrigerator will have more souvenirs.
So where all have you traveled, and you know what are your favorite locations?
I have traveled to Dubai. I have traveled. This year, I had my tickets to Istanbul, Turkey, which I had to cancel. So, but yes, there are a lot of plans to travel more ahead. So this corona has made all my plans. But I'm hoping things will be fine in a year and we all will be able to travel. So I will fulfill all my bucket list. I will tick all my wish list. And it's not about traveling outside India. Even in India, I love so many places. I want to explore Himachal. Last year in May, I was in Kashmir. So it's like heaven, heaven.
We were neighbors. So last entire May, we were in Himachal Pradesh. So almost 20 to 30 days we were around Himachal.
Wow.
So we
Especially in
drove.
the forest, we miss those places. Even Ladakh is on my wish list. But let's see hope when it fulfills.
So this travel is with your family, or you travel for
No, I'm not a solo traveler. I told you, no, I am one of the most boring person. I cannot tra I'm not into solo traveling. I need my family everywhere. I want my children everywhere. So yes, all family travels.
Superb. So I'm done with the questions, but ये एक दिमाग में चल रहा है अभी भी क्वेश्चन. So let me just ask you. So ये जो पोज है, even I commented ये कॉन्जरिंग का जो पोज है.
हाँ
So we can inform all the movie directors and all that this particular artist is available to enact as Conjuring for your movie. So you can have a main cast, and Conjuring के जब भी ऐसे stills रहते हैं तो रीना कैन हेल्प यू आउट.
हाँ I've heard they hire stuntmen, body doubles for actors. So, when they are making some scary horror movies, yeah, they can approach me. Yes,
So
and
movie
anytime
director,
I will.
yeah, and short film movies, horror movies. So you have an artist available in Hyderabad, so feel free to get
So if the actress is not able to do all this to scare the heroes in the movies, I will come and I will help them out.
Cool. Thanks, Reena. That was very spontaneous, very natural way of answering the rapid fire questions. I mean, we got to know you well. So now the main question. So if you become the chief minister, what would you focus on?
Like Mr. Narendra Modi has made June 21st the yoga day. I will say that from now onwards, every day is yoga day. Yoga is compulsory. So there will be like people who will not wear mask, they are asking for a fine of 1,000 rupees. So whoever will not do yoga for 1 hour or half an hour, they will also be fined.
Good one. That's a nice way you're putting it. Though it is like very humorous. One of the reasons I think I should also start practicing. I think this 1 minute CM has also encouraged me to do a lot of things. I've learned a lot, like you mentioned, Rina. I've learned from Raja about barefoot walking. So I'm trying to walk in the evenings, except for the heat waves which are around for the last week. Barefoot, I've seen a lot of benefits. I'm having deep sleep when I'm walking barefoot in my colony. So I walk for around 3 kilometers barefoot on a tar road. It is just awesome. So, and yeah, seeing your pictures, I'm also getting to I'm getting inspired to get into yoga. So my
Yeah,
wife has
again, I have
been
not traveled. That's wonderful. But I just wanted to have this conversation in a lighter way. So the pictures are really secondary. It's just nothing. But again, if we come towards pranayama and meditation, yoga is not complete without pranayama and meditation. Because nowadays people are not looking at the mental health. Everybody wants to look very physical appealing. And of course, yoga will give you the physical benefits, but the mental health is very important. And if it is not taken care of, we will hear a lot of people doing suicides, going into depression because of, this corona happening. I have heard that many youngsters just staying at home the whole day are getting depressed. So I feel that the mental well-being is very, very, very important. And pranayama and meditation are is a part of yoga. And if practiced well, even if you are not into yoga asanas, and if early in the morning you wake up and you just sit for 5 minutes and you meditate, or if you do pranayama 5 minutes, you will start feeling changes in just 1 week. In just 1 week.
So, do you avoid parties because you have to get up early and, you know, do all these things? Neither as a
I'm
chief.
not an, I have one funny story to share in this. I'm not at all a night person. I love to sleep early and rise early. But you know, sometimes few friends' birthday parties, I have to go when they treat me. And it literally just around 10:30, I'm like, they all are dancing and I'm yawning. So they are like, whenever we gather, so they are like, just like Cinderella, by 10:30, 11, Rina will start yawning. And they're like, one at one of my friend's birthday party, she was like, Rina, it's my birthday party, you have to look happy, you are yawning like crazy. I'm like, why do you guys keep parties late so night? We can party around 6 years in the afternoon. They're like, oh God, you are one crazy woman. So sometimes there are many of my friends who don't invite me also. They say that she's one sleepy head, she won't come. I'm not a night person at all. Once in a while, yes. Otherwise, I am happy sleeping. Right now, in the 2 months, I see people posting, we saw this on Netflix, we saw this, we were awake till 5 o'clock watching this. Not my cup of tea. I cannot, I just cannot.
Good, good. Thanks, Rina. And friends, one of the reasons, you know, I mean, Rina, we had Rina. It's not only about the different poses, difficult poses she does, but please remember that Corona is going to be here for a while, and it's very important that we all take care of our health, immunity, ourselves. So it will at least take a year or two for the vaccines to come, and you know, until then we have to maintain social distancing and also maintain good health. So we have to take time for some of these things. And Reena, thanks for taking time out, and you know, very humble, very nice, subtle way of putting things across. So all the best with whatever you're doing. You have inspired me, and I'm sure with a lot of others who are yoga. So we'll keep watching you. People do follow Reena and inspire her. You know, whenever she posts the pictures, it is not only about herself and the difficult poses to make others jealous, but it is also to pass on a message. One of the reasons you should follow some inspiring people, inspiring stories, is because that reminds us, they saying that, hey, this is what we are missing, or this is the next level of doing it. So we have to grow every day, and we have to learn something new on a day-to-day basis. So thank you, Reena. With that, we close the show.
I had a wonderful time. I had a very nice time. Thank you. Thank you, Ravi, for this. And you conducted it so well. I was like, before starting it, I was a little reluctant what kind of a questions it be. And we are talking for the first time, but
Yes.
you still made me feel like we are talking. It's like we are friends since long. So thank you so much for making me feel comfortable. And I had a wonderful time. Thank you so much.
You didn't socialize much in your school. मैं आपके स्कूल में ही था, so that's the reason you didn't. चलो, थैंक यू रीना, ऑल द बेस्ट. थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स. सो यू हैव अ न्यू फ्रेंड, सो आई विल शेयर द सोशल मीडिया हैंडल्स फॉर प्रीना. सो डू फॉलो हर एंड प्लीज एनकरेज हर, एंड डू लेट अस नो इफ यू हैव एनी इंस्पिरेशनल फ्रेंड्स विद यू, सो यू कैन जॉइन मी फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉक. थैंक यू गाइस, हैव अ ग्रेट वीकेंड, हैप्पी सैटरडे. थैंक यू
Happy
रीना.
to everybody, and yes, keep doing yoga.
थैंक
Thank
यू.
you, Ravi. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Welcome. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.